Now we are going to learn how to integrate our Spring application with the database using JDBC API. So for that, the module that we are going to use is Spring-JDBC module. In case of Spring, whenever you want to work with a particular framework, then you need to go in for different modules. If you want to connect to the database, then you need to use Spring-JDBC module or Spring-ORM module. If you want to work, create a web application, you need Spring web module. So similarly, here we are going to integrate our Spring application with the database. So we are using JDBC API. The module is Spring-JDBC module. Okay. Now, what is the advantage of using Spring-JDBC module compared to that we have worked with Java? Usually what you do, you create a simple Java application. If you want to connect to the database, you use JDBC. Correct? Okay. What are the steps that we will do if we want to connect our Java application to the database using JDBC? First is we will create a connection object. For creating the connection object, we need to specify what is the username. Give the password and the URL to the database to which we want to connect. Then we need to create a prepared statement object. In the prepared statement object, we need to specify what is the SQL query, whether you want to insert or you want to update or you want to delete or you want to query the database. That is, you need to write the SQL query. Then based on the SQL query, you need to set the values. Correct? You will call prepared statement dot set string of, set int of. So you will be setting the values for the placeholders. For placeholder 1, set name. For placeholder 2, set city. Like that, you will be setting the values. Then you will call prepared statement dot execute or execute update. Only then the steps for connecting to the database will be complete. Together with that, it is your duty that you need to close the database connection. Other than this, you also should take care of the exception. So as a Java developer, when you want to connect your Java application to the database using JDBC, these are the steps that you will write. But now we are going to use Spring. In case of Spring, what is the process? Spring will take care of all the low-level API. First is, I want to connect to MySQL database. So what I have to do, I need to inform what is the username, URL, password, and to which database I want to connect to Spring. Spring will establish a connection for me. So it will be done by Spring. So this part is done by me. Creating a connection will be done by Spring. Next. Creating a prepared statement will be done by Spring. But how it will know what type of SQL query I am going to give? So giving the SQL query is my job. Using this SQL query, Spring will create the prepared statement. Okay. So Spring will create the connection. Spring will create the prepared statement based on the SQL query that you are presenting. Then after that, how Spring will know what are the values for the placeholders that you need to provide. See, for placeholder 1, you add value name. For placeholder 2, you set city. For placeholder 3, you set mobile number. So those things has to be provided by you. So this part also has to be provided by you. Once you have given the placeholders or once you have set the values for the placeholders, Spring will call ps.execute. That is, it will execute the prepared statement. After executing the prepared statement, it is the job of Spring to close the database connection. Okay, so you don't have to even close the database connection. If you notice, opening and closing the database connection is done by Spring. Creating a prepared statement is done by Spring. Executing the prepared statement is done by Spring. As a developer, you need to give the important details, that is the database specific details, to which database you are connecting, what is the username, URL and password, what type of query you want to execute. Okay. And what about the exceptions? In case of Java, you always use a try and catch and you take care of all the exceptions. In case of Spring, all the database specific exceptions also will be converted into runtime exceptions. So Spring will take care of your exceptions also. So as a developer, you have to take care of DB specific details, then what type of query you want to execute, then setting the placeholders. Okay, so I have just given an idea of how things are happening. Now let us see that in detail. What is Spring JDBC module? Spring JDBC module helps to integrate our Spring application with the database. Spring takes care of all the low-level details. It will convert all your JDBC specific SQL exceptions into its own runtime exceptions. Again, I'm repeating, Spring supports only runtime exceptions. Whatever exceptions are there in Spring are extending only runtime exceptions. So you don't have to use a try catch. If the exception is thrown, it will be captured by the JVM automatically. These runtime exceptions are data access exceptions. Okay. The Spring JDBC module has four different packages. One is core, data source, object, and support. Fine. What is the purpose of core? This core package has the main functionality of JDBC. In this, it has got JDBC template class. This JDBC template class is responsible for whatever we were talking about. This is the central class or this is the main class. This class is responsible for establishing a connection, creating a prepared statement, closing the connection, then taking care of the exceptions, taking care of the transactions. All these will be taken care by this JDBC template. Okay, now how this JDBC template will know what are all the database specific details? So for that, we need a data source. That data source is available in data source package. This data source package has a utility class called as data source, where you will be giving the database specific details. Okay. How do you give the database specific details like the URL, username and password? If you see in Java, we write everything inside the parameters, driver manager dot get connection like that, or you provide it in the properties file. So similarly, here also we are going to provide it in the properties file, that is application dot properties file. Okay. Other than that, it has got two more packages. One is object, the other one is support. Object is for executing the queries. Whenever you want to query the database and execute the query, then you need this object package. Support. Support is exclusively for working with exceptions. Okay, see, you can see that. Provides SQL exception translation into generic exception. That is, all the database specific exceptions will be converted into Spring specific generic exceptions. Fine. Now, whatever I have told there, I have given in the form of a chart. You can just have a look. Define the connection parameters. That is the username, URL, and password that you have to provide. Open the connection. Based on the connection parameters that you have given, Spring will open a connection. Specify the SQL statement. That is, provide the SQL query. Then, declare the parameters and provide parameters values. That is, provide values for the placeholders, 1, name, 2, city, like that. That also you have to provide. Spring will create the prepared statement and execute the statement. Okay, fine. Now, set up the loop to iterate through the results. Now, when you are going to work with result set, you are giving select star from book. It means what? Like I'm querying the database. Your result set is coming back. Now, you need to iterate. Who is responsible for iterating it? Spring is responsible for iterating through that particular set of values. But while iterating, what should I do? I have to take the name from that particular column and assign it to a variable name. I have to take the city and assign it to a variable city. So that process has to be done by you. So do the work for each iteration. Spring knows to loop through that. But what is the value that has to be set? That you need to inform. And what about the exception handling part? Spring will take care of it. Transaction, Spring will take care of it. Glossing the connection statement, result set, everything will be taken care by Spring. So if you see, whatever work you have been doing till now in Java, that is, you remember we used to write a model DAW class where we create a connection object, we give the configuration details, username, URL, password, you don't need all those. Then coming back to the main class, where you create a prepared statement, you call setter method, set string of all those, part of it will be removed with the help of Spring. Now we were talking about the JDBC template. This JDBC template is the core class or the central class in the JDBC core package. It is responsible for opening and closing a connection, creating and executing the prepared statement, executing the SQL queries, update statements, stored procedures. This is very important, stored procedures. Then iterate through the result set. Again, I'm saying it knows to loop through the result set. But what is the value to be set for what variable? That you need to give. Because it doesn't know, okay, ID has to be given to ID, city has to be set to city. Those information you need to provide, Spring will loop through that result set values. Okay, it handles the JDBC exceptions, converts it into Spring specific generic exception. Now, to work with Spring JDBC, as usual, you need to create a Spring starter project, then add Spring boot starter JDBC. Then if you are working with MySQL, add MySQL database driver, or Oracle means Oracle specific driver. Second part is done. The third part is data source details. Where to give the URL, username, password in application.properties. So till now, what we have seen is we have a main class. From the main class, we go to the service. With service, we stopped ourselves. From service, you can move on to repository. So as usual, you will be having a repository interface and a repository implementation class. The repository implementation class should be annotated with @repository. The service layer is annotated with @service. Similarly, the repository implementation should be annotated with @repository. To this class, you will auto-wire JDBC template. So it means main depends on service, service depends on repository, repository depends on JDBC template, JDBC template depends on the data source. The data source is the place where you are giving the database specific details, username, URL and password. Only then this JDBC template can establish a connection with the database. This is the data source specific properties. Guys, you cannot give your own details, like this is by default available. You remember when we were working with Spring, for @value annotation, we used to give within double quotes, dollar curly brace, employee.name. I usually tell that if your domain model is employee, you need to give employee.name, employee.city. For these variables, we are giving value in the properties file. So similarly, there is a data source class which is expecting value for driver class name, URL, username and password. So they have added @value annotation above those instance variables. So the value name is this big they have added. So you should not give your own properties name. Here we are using MySQL. So we are giving the MySQL driver name, URL, username and password. Now let us see how to perform CRUD operations. Thank you.